In this tutorial, we're going to use NeuronWriter plus ChatGPT and a tool called Perplexity to create a SEO optimized blog post. So let's get started. NeuronWriter is an SEO optimizer, and it uses semantic models like natural language processing and search engine analysis and competitor data to help you write articles that are optimized to rank well on search engines. We're going to combine NeuronWriter with ChatGPT to generate content and then transform that content into SEO-friendly optimized content. We're also going to use Perplexity, which is a free tool that is at Perplexity.ai, and we're going to use this to generate FAQs. I'll have links to all these tools in the video description, and I'll also include information for the different prompts that I use in the video description, so you can check there. So this article is going to be about the hot springs near Los Angeles. So the main keyword that I'm targeting is hot springs near Los Angeles. I'm going to take that keyword phrase, and we're going to go over to NeuronWriter. So we're going to create a new query and paste this phrase into NeuronWriter, and we're going to run a scan. This takes a couple seconds. So once that's done, you click on the scan and you wait for it to process. So when it's running the scan, it's basically looking at the top 30 results in Google, and it's analyzing all these websites to pull data from how they structure their websites, and it's going to provide that analysis to you so that you can make a better article than, you know, the top 30 ranking articles in Google for this keyword phrase. When it finishes scanning, you will get a list of all the articles that it is pulled in its analysis. So there's 30 total articles, and you can include as many of these as you want. What I do is I focus on the content score for these articles. So how optimized are they already? Because I want to include data from those, but I don't want to include data from, you know, articles that are not optimized. So in the first top 10, it looks like it's a good selection, but I'm going to include some more. This one is pretty well optimized, so I'll include that one. Anything that's green is pretty well optimized. So I'm going to include these additional two articles, so 12 articles total, and it's going to use that to basically help me improve my SEO for my article. Okay, so now that it's scanned those 12 different articles, it's come up with basically information for me that I need to use as I create this new article. It gives you a list of terms in article. It also gives you a list of terms that you should be using in your headings. So this is all very useful information. And if you want to go in and look at an analysis of the different websites that it's, you know, used, you can go in here and it gives you the exact URLs. So you can go and you can look at those sites. It also tells you like their Moz page authority, domain, page rank. You have to update to see that information, but it's all there for you if you want to dig deeper to see exactly what the competition is doing. You also, this is really helpful, it shows you the structure of the different articles, the headers that they're using. So all this information, you're going to take it and you're going to build a better article than what your competitors are doing. So the next thing we're going to do is we're going to move on to ChatGPT, but we're going to copy this list of terms, and I'm going to keep notes. So we're going to call this our content keywords. I'm just going to paste them there. We're also going to get our extended keywords, and we're going to get our heading terms that it wants us to use. I'm just going to take the H2, H3 because you only need to have one H1 term. So we're going to take the H2, H3 terms as well. And I created another group for these. And what I'm going to do is I put title keywords at the top, and then I'm going to close this box, kind of like HTML, and put title keywords at the bottom here, and then do the same for content keywords. And I'm doing this because we're going to be giving ChatGPT this information, and we want to separate it so that ChatGPT knows where these keywords need to be used. So now that we have our keywords, so we've done kind of that foundational research, now let's start writing our article, our blog. So I want a better title. So I have a prompt here. I'm writing a blog post based on the keyword hot springs near Los Angeles. Come up with 10 possible title ideas. Each title should incorporate the exact keyword. It should be no more than 60 characters in total. So this that I like. So I'm going to use this one, soak away stress, hot springs near Los Angeles. Make sure that this article includes all of the possible hot springs. So I'm going to pop over to Perplexity. So Perplexity is basically a site where you can ask it questions and it gives you responses. And what's unique about it is it tells you exactly where it's pulling the information from. So I had Perplexity give me a list of the top 20 hot springs in Los Angeles, and I told it do not include descriptions. Okay, so now that we have provided, we've generated our keywords, we know exactly which hot springs we want to write about. Now we need to tell ChatGPT what we want it to do. Okay, so here we go. So now it's ready for me to start giving it more instructions. Giving it the topic. So now it's ready for the keywords. So I'm going to give it the three different groups of keywords. Here are the first batch of header keywords. Now it's ready for the content keywords, content keywords group one, and now it's ready for the final set of keywords. So I'm giving it the final group of keywords, and I'm telling it to please wait for my instructions before it starts creating the blog post, because I want it to generate an outline before it just starts writing. So here we go. And now it's ready for my next instructions. Okay, so now I want it to write the outline for this blog. So I'm going to tell it, please write a detailed outline and wait for my instructions. Organize this outline into four sections. Section one, section two, section three, section four. Make sure to include these hot springs with any important information, including location, address, contact number, amenities, and reservations. So I'm giving it that prompt. And now it's building an outline and it's organizing it into sections. So now we're going to tell it to start writing section by section. So we're going to tell it to write section one. And the reason why we're breaking it up into sections is if you have it write everything at once, it's not going to write you very detailed information. It needs to just focus on each section at a time so that it can write as much as possible. So let's have it write section one. And so now we are basically getting our introduction section. Copy and pasting it into NeuronWriter. And with each section, we're going to start to see our SEO, like our optimization score, increase. So let's work our way through the entire blog and get everything over into NeuronWriter and see what additional optimization we'll need to do. So now we're telling it to write section two. I'm going to copy and paste this information over into NeuronWriter. Okay, so now we're going to have it start writing our actual sections about the hot springs. So I'm telling it to write section two, and I'm just reminding it of what I want it to do. Make sure to include one paragraph description, location, address, contact number, amenities, reservations. It may not be able to give me all of this information, but I want it to be as detailed as possible. And I found that sometimes you have to remind ChatGPT of exactly what you want it to do. So we're going to start, and now it's generating section two, and it's giving me a nice description for each hot springs. So let's bring this over to NeuronWriter. So this is our section two. And we see our score go up from 5 to 25, so that's good. And we're gonna be making some further improvements, but this is just, we're just getting the core information from ChatGPT right now. We're gonna do write section three, make sure to include the important information, and now it's creating section three. One thing to note is that sometimes ChatGPT includes like this kind of summary paragraph at the end of each piece of content it's generating, and sometimes this last paragraph isn't useful. So I often don't include it. And we're pasting a third section in NeuronWriter, and our score just jumped up a little bit. But like I said, we have more improvements to make here. So now let's go create the last section in ChatGPT. Section four, and copy this over into NeuronWriter, pasting this in NeuronWriter. And our score has just gone up a couple points to 30. I have it write a conclusion, and I'm telling it to write a two paragraph conclusion for this blog summarizing the important information. Make sure to use content keywords when possible. So once again, just reminding ChatGPT what to do. And now it's giving me a conclusion, which I'm going to add to NeuronWriter. I go and start optimizing this blog based on NeuronWriter's recommendation. ChatGPT got us up to a score of 30, but what we know is that of all the articles that we used in our analysis, the highest rated article has a score of 71, an SEO score of 71, and the median score is 60. So we need to be at least at 60 and, you know, in theory, like over 71. So we have to get this score up from 30 to 71. That said, we have a lot of things that we can do to make this article more optimized. So first, we're going to start with our title. So if you just click this title section, NeuronWriter will tell you the keywords that you should have in your title to basically have the most optimized title. We're going to say best hot springs. We tell this we need to have best hot springs. And then we're going to actually best hot springs near Los Angeles. And actually we did generate a title that should work. So soak away stress, and we're just going to modify it slightly by saying best hot springs in Los Angeles. Or near Los Angeles. So we've improved our title and we're using almost all of NeuronWriter's recommendations. So now we need to have a description. So let's say something like discover best hot springs near Los Angeles. Something like discover the best hot springs near Los Angeles for natural hot spring, say for relaxation in a natural hot spring environment, something like that. So we're using all of NeuronWriter's recommendation. and we're going to save this. And just improving our metadata, like our title and description, meta description, we're up to a 51 score. So that's great. And that was a really easy improvement to make. Thing to pay attention to in the terms and the phrases that NeuronWriter recommend is that it tells you basically like how often or how much you should be using specific terms and phrases. And anything in green lets you know that you're in a good sweet spot in terms of the amount that that phrase is used. So these are headers I'm looking at. So looking at terms, so green is the ideal. When it's getting into the orange, that's telling you like you're reaching the upper limit. And then red, you may want to reduce the occurrence of that. So if you have something in red and you want to bring down how often you're using it, you click on the phrase or the word, you have it highlighted for you in the text. So it'll show you where you're using that specific keyword, and you could just go in and you can remove it. So you can bring down your usage and get it in a more ideal range. So you'll see like the number on the left is how often you're actually using a keyword in your content, and the number on the right is the recommended amount that you should be using the keyword in your content. Next, let's look at our headers. So ChatGPT didn't quite follow my instructions on the headers, but that's an easy fix. So NeuronWriter tells you how often you should have certain keywords appearing in your H2 and H3 headers. So we're going to go through, and actually we need to transform some of these normal regular text into H3 headers. This actually should be an H2 header, and these should be H3. So each of the hot springs locations should be an H3. So I'm going to go through and convert all of these into H3 headers. Moving the headers gave me a little boost, but not quite a ton. But so next I'm going to look at changing the language in the headers. So for example, ChatGPT gave me a header of popular hot springs destinations. However, I see that the phrase hot springs in Los Angeles is only used 16% of the time in my headers. So I'm going to copy that term and I'm going to add it to this to say popular hot springs in Los Angeles. And that boosts the occurrence of that phrase, which boosts my score up to 54. So another example we see here, Beverly Hot Springs Spa is used 25% of the time. And we have Beverly Hot Springs, so we just add spa to that H3 header, and it's going to give us a boost in that phrase. So our score just went up another 2 points. So this is just a process of going through your terms and working your way through your headers and just seeing where you can add more of these optimized terms. So that's what I'm going to do now. For example, so I have here hidden gems and natural springs, and I see that I should use the phrase mineral water. It's only been used like 8%. So if you click on a phrase and you just copy it, you can then easily add it. So I can just add natural mineral water springs, and now my score is up to 61. So I'm going to go through and just make a few more improvements on my headers. Tweaked all of my headers, and now we're at a score of 64. So we have a bit to go. And I haven't even started with the terms and article. Before I do that, we need a FAQ for this. And this is where the power of Perplexity is really useful. So NeuronWriter has the ability to generate FAQs for you. I find that they have good FAQ questions, but their answers aren't so great. And what's great about their FAQ suggestions is they are pulling from what people are asking on the internet. So they're looking at like the most frequently asked questions. So if you look in this right side panel and you click on outline, and there's a tab, questions, and it's pulling from people also ask the top, most asked questions about this keyword topic. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to copy a question and bring it over into Perplexity and have Perplexity give me responses to this question. So Perplexity gave me a response. However, you can't copy and paste information from Perplexity because it would be plagiarized, because it's literally pulling directly from articles. And this isn't formatted in the correct way for FAQ response. So we're gonna copy this over to ChatGPT. We're gonna have ChatGPT rewrite this information into a nice FAQ response for us. Telling ChatGPT to rewrite the information below into a short response. Make sure to include content keywords when possible. So I'm reminding it to use the content keywords from NeuronWriter in the response that it creates. And I'm copying and pasting the response from Perplexity. So now let's have it write a response for us. and it does so. It gives us a longer response than what we need, but that's okay. I'm just going to take the first paragraph and I'm going to modify it a little bit. Okay, so I copied the response from ChatGPT, the rewritten FAQ, and I modified it a bit. I condensed it and I added more of these terms with, you know, to this FAQ response. So now if I want to, you know, I'm going to include the actual question, and all I need to do is go over to NeuronWriter, put my cursor where I want that question to appear, and bring it over as a H3. You can also make it an H2. Sometimes they have different impact on SEO, but I think I'm just going to keep this as an H3. So what I'll do now is go through these questions in NeuronWriter and add another question over and then get a response from Perplexity. So another question is, are the Tecopa hot springs free? So let's put this over here and we're going to copy this over to Perplexity and get a response. But he gave me a response to this and it says, yes, this hot springs is free. So I'm going to copy the response and then bring it over to ChatGPT to rewrite it for me. So I've gone through the different questions that people ask in NeuronWriter, and I've added, let's see, about 5 FAQs. And what you can also use Perplexity for is when you do a search, so I did a search, does LA have hot springs? It will give you ideas for related searches that people are doing. So these could be other FAQ questions that are often, you know, people often Google for. So I'm going to also include a few of these FAQs from Perplexity because this is also information that people need related to the topic of hot springs near Los Angeles. Hit FAQs, and now looking at my content score, I'm at a 66, so I'm really close. And what NeuronWriter shows you is where you need to focus your optimization. So if you just need a few more points, you can look and you can see, okay, my title's great. This is the title right here. My headings can use more work, so they're only 31% optimized. So this lets me know that I should focus on the headings that I'm using throughout the content. And this also shows you what percentage of usage of suggested terms you have in your content, the length. So we see the length, the target is 1600 words roughly, and I'm at 1945 words. And it also shows you your keyword stuffing risk. So keyword stuffing is where you're basically just putting keywords into the content unnecessarily to try to game search engines into ranking higher. And it's not good to do that, you can get penalized. So our keyword stuffing risk is low, so that's great. And it also shows us our readability score. So the readability is how easy is your content to read. And it's ranked on a score of 0 to 100. So 0 means the readability is very difficult, and 100 means it's very easy. So it does not mean that 100 is better than 0. The readability should be adequate to the topic and your audience. The longer the sentences and the more difficult the words, the lower the readability. We're at a score of, it looks like it's like 38. So ideally, it would be nice to have a bit of a higher readability score, to be like somewhere in the middle, or you know, maybe 50 or 60. So you can go through and you can do things like even looking at sentences and removing unnecessary words. I mean, ChatGPT often adds in a lot of kind of like unnecessary fluff. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to go through my headers once again, add in some more optimization, and then try to simplify a few sentences. And then after that, we're going to be ready to publish this article.